Hi, hello. Hot. Today is the first day for holiday Starbucks drinks. I got grande sugar cookie almond latte with blonde espresso. That's a long one. Hi. I feel like it's been forever since I've done one of these. So I have a few updates if you're not following me on Twitch or anywhere else. I think in one of the last vlogs I was talking about how I had two auditions coming up, and that was like way back in September, and I actually won both. Right now I'm playing with a little orchestra in LA, and I'm also playing principal with the New Mexico Phil, and that's just kind of like a temporary position, but it has me commuting between LA and Albuquerque pretty often. So tomorrow I'm driving out to Albuquerque and I'll be there for an entire month. There's a lot of concerts happening in November, so it just made sense for me to stay out there instead of going back and forth so often. So anyway, if I have to stay more than a week, I usually try to drive out just so that I have my car. It's about an 11-hour drive, and like with stopping and everything, it ends up being about 12 hours, so it's a long one. I did it last month for the first time by myself and I was okay, so we're gonna do it again tomorrow. So I'm just trying to get some things ready today. I gotta go get my oil changed and I gotta pack. I also just in the last couple of weeks stopped streaming on Twitch, and that was a super big deal because it's been kind of like my main job for the last 3 years. I honestly do truly feel so much better since I stopped, but I also just miss being able to like talk to you guys every day. So yeah, I thought it was a good time to start vlogging a little more, so hopefully you'll see a little bit more of me over here on YouTube. And yeah, I think that's it. Okay, I am back. All right, I have to start packing up all of this. I decided I'm gonna take my PC and like my microphones and interface and all of that stuff. But yeah, I'm gonna try to pack this all up right now and I'll check back in a little bit. I just went to the store. I picked up some snacks for the drive tomorrow. These are my favorite protein bars. They're like Power Crunch, like they're wafery. They're like those wafer cookie things with the frosting on the inside. Honestly, they taste pretty good. So I got two of those. I got the lemon one and chocolate. I was craving Cheez-Its and I was at Sprouts, so obviously they don't have Cheez-Its there, but I got these cauliflower crackers. I don't know if these are gonna be any good, but I'll let you know. To drink, I really like these coconut waters, but I like it when it has pulp in it. I know that's kind of weird. No, no, there's something about the texture that I love so much. And that's it. I feel like that should get me through the day. I'm gonna stop for coffee in the morning and then I'll stop for lunch too, so I should be okay. I feel like those are more for like if I get bored and I just want to eat something. I'm gonna try to leave tomorrow at 5 a.m. maybe even earlier if I can. I think I'm just gonna like roll out of bed and look like a full-on fucking mess, but that's okay, right? No one's gonna see me. I'm just gonna be driving in the car. Well, you'll see me. I guess the whole internet will see me. Just did my first refuel. It's a little after 9 right now and I've made it to Arizona. So far so good. I ended up leaving right at 5 and I stopped for coffee. So we're making really good time. It says I have about 7.5 hours left, so I think I'll be there by like 5, 5:30. I don't think I talked about this earlier, but I'm staying the whole month in New Mexico. I'm actually house sitting for someone. I use this website, sometimes it's called Trusted House Sitters, and for this one, they have 2 horses, so I'm super excited. Okay, I made it to Flagstaff. I got my second coffee of the day. This lighting is horrible. I'm a little bit more than halfway done and it's about 12:30. I didn't really stop for lunch. I just grabbed a coffee and a bagel. So I'm just gonna eat while I drive and hopefully we make it by 5. We're in New Mexico! Yeah. I cannot stop thinking about this. The other night I had the most vivid dream that Rhett from Rhett and Link, the one with the longer hair, I had a dream that he was my dad and he and his wife just like fully welcomed me into their family. And I remember it was like so nice. It was just like one of those dreams that felt so real. I feel like he's not that much older than me, so I don't know why I thought of him as a father figure. He's probably like, what, like 15 years older than me? Maybe less? It was just, it was just so vivid. So let's carve our names into this tree. Then lay beneath the beauty of a leaf. Okay, hi. I made it to this beautiful house. I don't really know how I got this lucky. Like, this place is insanely beautiful. It's totally like New Mexico style, so lots of like wood beams. There's this beautiful open indoor garden. I was like so dead driving up here after driving for 12 hours, and now I'm like so excited. Oh my gosh, I can't believe I get to stay here for a whole month. I thought I'd do a Sprouts haul, but these are all the things that I love to eat, and I don't get to do it very often just because I live with more people than just myself. And they don't want to eat like this all the time, which is totally reasonable. So, first off, Kodiak oatmeal. I just got some of this stock cold brew because I wasn't sure what the coffee situation would be like. I got a bunch of these little brown cow yogurts. I used to eat these when I was little all the time and they were my favorite, and I haven't had them since I was like 7. So when I found them, I was like, oh my gosh. I have this one maple flavor. Oh my gosh, guys. If you like maple things, it's amazing. I'm trying to limit my sugar intake because I've been a little crazy with it. So I got these. I'm gonna try these. It's like chocolate, but it's sweetened with monk fruit. I don't know, it could be awful. I got tea. This is detox tea. I don't know if it detoxes you, but I think it just tastes really good. This is my favorite pasta. It's the bonza rigatoni. It's just chickpeas. So good protein. I got some sauce. And then for my coffee, I've been seeing all the TikTok girlies do this. It's this nut pods, almond and coconut creamer, but it's French vanilla, but not sweetened. I have a really big sweet tooth and I really shouldn't be having as much sugar as I do. So I got this. It's like liquid stevia, but it's vanilla flavored. I've heard that when stevia is liquefied like this, it doesn't have any of that weird aftertaste. So yeah, I will update you if that's good tomorrow. And then just because obviously I'm not gonna cook tonight after driving 12 hours, I just got a nice little sushi. But yeah, so tomorrow I have two rehearsals. One's at 10 a.m. and then the other one I think is at like 7 or 7:30 at night. And then I have a concert the day after that. So it's gonna be a busy weekend. So yeah, I think I'm just gonna eat this and then maybe practice a little bit and get cozy and go to bed. Thank you. just got back from my first rehearsal of the day, and it was stressful. If you're a musician, maybe this is a common experience, but I stress myself out so much more than I need to. I feel like with French horn, like, it's an expectation that you're gonna miss some notes, like you're gonna crack some or whatever. It's just the nature of the instrument. It happens, and it's kind of like something you can't really control. But whenever it happens, like, even if it's the tiniest little crack, I'm like, ah, they're gonna fire me. Today I was just having a little trouble with the accuracy, but I don't think it was as bad as it was in my head, so I don't know. We'll see. I have another rehearsal tonight at 7:30, so I have... Whoa. Anyway, I have another rehearsal tonight at 7:30, so I have a few hours. What time is it? It is... It's 1:30 right now, so I have a good chunk of the day. So I'm just making some lunch right now, and then I think it's such a beautiful day out right now. It's 70 degrees and sunny. So I think I'm gonna go take a walk down by the river. So I'll take you guys with me. I also, oh my gosh, I was so stressed out that I went out and bought a bottle of wine. So I'm very excited to crack that open tonight. You might have seen the footage, but last night I made myself like a nice little bath and watched Gilmore Girls, and it was the best vibes ever. So I'm thinking a glass of wine will add just the perfect amount of coziness to that. The concert is tomorrow, so it's a really quick turnaround. It's just one day of two rehearsals. So I don't really want to practice that much today, just so I can like make it through tonight and tomorrow. I forgot to mention that the program this week is Mendelssohn 4. The other piece is a new symphony written by a guy that's a local named Daniel Crafts. Doing new pieces is always fun. Just because it's a, there's like no reference for what it's supposed to sound like, but today it was totally fine. The Mendelssohn is the one that's hard, so. I'm heading off to rehearsal number 2. I cannot figure out how to get the fucking heat to work in this house. It's literally 58 degrees in here right now. This morning when I got out of bed, it was 52 inside the house. I need to figure it out. I've been trying to read the manual, but yeah, it's been my challenge so far, but that's not a big deal. Anyway, I'm gonna head off and I'll see you a little later. Hello, I'm coming to you from the floor. I just finished my nighttime rehearsal. I got out like 30 minutes early, so thank you so much. It went so much better than the morning rehearsal. Like, I felt totally fine. And yeah, tomorrow all I have is a concert, so it should be less stressful, I would say, from here on out. Since I got out a little early, I was actually able to stop at Target and get some cozy stuff. I also got protein waffles, which I really love these. These are the buttermilk and vanilla protein waffles from like the Target brand. I don't know why I got those. I feel like I only bought breakfast food. I picked up this Dr. Teal's sleep lotion. And I'll let you know if it works, if it knocks me out. Last time I was playing here, I had a really weird housing situation. There's like a handful of people that commute in to play in the orchestra here in Albuquerque. They usually just put you with like a homestay with someone that's sort of connected with the orchestra. And last time I was here, I just like, I had a weird time, and it was nothing against the homestay people or
the house or anything like that. I think I didn't sleep at all the first night that I stayed at that homestay. So I went out the next day and bought like the maximum dose of melatonin. Don't recommend this, but I think I doubled up on it and I passed the fuck out. I think the next night I slept like 16 hours. It was insane. I feel like I'm weird because like substances really affect me. Like I'll have a glass of wine and be like, that's it. That's all I can do. I remember a few years ago, I got stung by a bee on my finger right here. I'm like very slightly allergic to bees. My finger swelled up like crazy. I think I have a picture of it. I think this is so bad, but I think I didn't have health insurance at the time. So I was like, well, I guess I gotta just take a Benadryl and see what happens. I remember I was out with a bunch of friends and I took a Benadryl. I was driving my car and then all of a sudden I was like, I cannot drive right now. And I had to pull the car over and my friend Andrew had to drive the rest of the way to the restaurant. And I don't remember anything from the rest of that day. It's like I fully blacked out on one Benadryl. I'm gonna guess that this is gonna work. But honestly, I would take my low tolerance over like a high tolerance. It's just like, I know my limit, you know? I also got this Method Men body wash because this is another weird thing. I feel like men's scents are way better than like women oriented scents. Why are we even like genderizing scents at this point? Like, why does this need to be a man soap? I guess it's just marketing. I just really love soaps that are tree scented. And I got some razors so I can have really smooth legs. I finally got the heat working, by the way. Oh my gosh, I feel so stupid. There's like a remote on every wall that you can use to like change the temperature of the house. I just have never lived in like a high-tech house before, so I thought that that was something else. I'm living large. Look how big this TV is. I mean, it looks small from that angle, but my god. It's gotta be like 100 inches. No. Do they make TVs that big? I don't know. I'm bad at measurements. I'm in the office right now, and the office is like 2 times as big as my bedroom at home. Honestly, guys, trusted house sitters, like, oh my god, this is crazy. I feel like I almost want to like gatekeep it. If you're a classical musician and you're taking auditions, oh my gosh, this website, like, life-changing. Okay, this atrium is something else. Look at this. This is the bedroom, and then you walk out here, and there's like all of this. It's so beautiful. Oh my gosh. It's such a nice day today outside. I'm just about to leave to go play my concert. So yeah, that should be fun. And then tonight I have nothing planned, so I'm very excited. That wine bath last night, beautiful. That was amazing. Can't wait to do it again tonight. I'm just living the life here. So yeah, I'm gonna go play my concert and I'll see you guys in a little bit.